So welcome to the inaugural Stada Video Awards 2018.
Don't matter.
Let's just...
It's nearly Christmas, it is November the 29th, and we are starting to put the Christmas tree up, getting a festive spirit. The ladies are currently fussing the tree, zhuzhing it up so that we can spread out the plastic branches and put some baubles and tinsel on it.
We have a core number of the team that have been here since day one, pretty much. Even though we've been through a lot of ups and you know, bad times, they've stuck with the business.
And Luke is deputising for Sax, who's off at the minute. Luke, what are you working on at the minute?
I'm just doing a motion graphics video for a client who has a client who produces brake pads. So we've got some overhead footage looking down on a car, which is actually 3D, which is Jeff.
Where do I start? Luke is the longest member, serving member of the team. He was here pretty much from day one and has grown massively in the 5 years now, is it?
So short,
some of the stuff that you do is just amazing. You pretty much knock it out of the park. You come into your own, I think, when you're mentoring people and coaching people. I think you enjoy that sort of stuff, which I'm quite good to hear. So a round of applause.
Let's go around the room. Everyone's favourite Christmas movie. Favourite Christmas movie?
Yeah. Grinch.
So Jacob joined us, over a year ago now, is it? I remember the interview process. I remember getting your CV. I remember seeing your work. I remember having long conversations with Saxon, thinking this kid needs to work for me. JJ? Jacob, who's our 3D guy. Jacob, what are you working on at the minute?
I'm working on a brake pad. I'm trying to get it photorealistic, working on.
Now this doesn't sound overly excited when we say working on a brake pad, but I think JJ's more excited about this than his...
Yeah, especially when I've got the real thing in front of me.
And some of the work you're creating is just beyond insane. I have to say, I'm massively impressed with what you're doing. I mean, I thought I was a perfectionist with stuff. You put me to shame. But I really appreciate you sticking with us and just, you know, helping us get through it. You've elevated that side of the business tremendously, and I appreciate that, and thank you very much.
It's that sort of thing that doesn't go unrecognised. I log that sort of stuff, and I'm keen that when we get to a stage where we're reaching the successes we want to get to, I want to give back as much as I physically can to that core team that have been with me through thick and thin.
Tony, graphic designer, and Rebecca just went disappearing over there. So we're looking at the new, well, not a new brand, but a refresh of the Stada brand. And Tony is working on this kind of, what would you call this? Like a mind map sort of thing.
Yeah, it's what's a matrix of some kind.
And something just, matrix, that makes more sense. But if I just turn that around, you can just quickly see.
So just a way of ordering all your thoughts and kind of almost like a process of elimination as well.
Yeah, and I think it's such a clever way of doing it. Tony, longest interview on the planet. A year and a bit. It was a cash flow thing. It was just, I wanted to hire him from day one technically, but you know, my accountant screaming at me going, no, one step at a time. It's nice to have someone more my age bracket. it's great having Tony around. The level of skill with design as well, he turns things around like instantly and really quick. And it's just lovely to have you on the team, and I appreciate it. And the level of design that you created is fantastic. And I cannot wait to do the new brand, the rebrand. So great to have you on the team, thank you.
Well done. Ash, favorite Christmas movie?
Elf.
Oh, that's mine.
God. You can have the same.
No, it's
right.
Totally different.
No. Aisling was the first person to go through the incredibly tough interview process that Kat has introduced, but it works. It absolutely works. We've got a really good quality candidate through.
Marketing coordinator.
Ash, she's new member.
First Christmas.
First Christmas at Stada.
It's great to have you on full time as well. 3 days a week wasn't enough for me. It's like, no, we need more. 3 days is not enough. What's she doing? So I'm glad you're with us full time. And some of the stuff you're doing is incredible. It's really kind of lifting that kind of digital marketing side of things. But it's good that you're taking on more control of stuff by yourself. So there's a really good opportunity there. So it's good to have you on the team.
Just the last little bits, because we wanted to add some introductions, like custom introductions, including a name for each of the scripts.
Yeah. Saxon. So Saxon's been around. He's been around the block a few times. So we've known each other for a while. I've got a really old picture of Sax. Have you seen the picture of when I did that talk, when I first met Sax?
Yeah.
That talk at the college where he looks about 4 year old, which was sweet, really sweet. Kat joined us originally as business development manager and literally turned stuff around within like a couple of weeks. She's introduced us some to big clients. She's helped us basically double revenue within a year.
Come on, a bit more enthusiasm, guys. Hey.
But it was always my plan that my BDM was originally going to be, or eventually we're going to end up being my kind of right-hand person, the second in command type of thing, so I could then move away from the company and concentrate on actually growing the company. But you've done an amazing job and you have literally turned things around, so I appreciate that, so thank you. So if I had any message to the team, it would be thank you for having faith in me as a person, as a business owner. I haven't got everything right all the time, but I am willing to stick my neck on the line. I am willing to push forward, do everything that I can to grow this business. And I appreciate you supporting me and my goals within the business, and the commitment and the level of loyalty has been, you know, incredible.
Miracle on 34th Street.
That's what you said last year, isn't it?
Yeah, that's my favourite Christmas film.
So I was headhunting somebody she worked with, because I didn't know about Lauren at the time, just FYI. But she said, no, I'm happy where I am, thank you very much. And but she said, however, I know somebody who, and she's already sent you a CV. So we got in touch, she came in for an interview. I remember the interview really well. Lauren.
Hey.
Is our accounts exec. What are you working on at the minute, Lauren?
Space to trade website amends. Okay. So I'm just liaising with Alex to make sure he's done all the amends.
Great stuff.
That they want, and then bits that he's missed off, I'll rewrite like I've done and then send it back.
It was a big investment for us at the time because we didn't really need it, if I'm being totally honest, but I thought I knew we would. And then you came in and fucking hell, you've gone from digital marketing person to account management to this, that and the other and done all sorts. You're doing incredibly well in a very pressurised environment, so I really appreciate that, and the future is very bright for you. I know people aren't going to be around forever. I know we're not going to have the same staff in 15 years' time, potentially. But right now, through these difficult times where we're literally treading through the mud to grow this business, as a lot of businesses are, I really appreciate those that believe, and this is the key thing actually, I think this is probably more important than anything and means more to me than anything else, is that they believe in what I'm trying to achieve.
Marcos, favourite Christmas movie?
Gremlins!
What do I say about Marcos? Best one. Well, he was the best dressed until Jacob came along, and now it's a competition between the two. Marcos.
Hello.
Is our videographer. Just running through what you're doing, Marcos.
Well,
what
today,
you're working on?
I'm working on a TV show that we're actually making for Beyond TV. I'm currently in the first edit, so I'm actually hacking down an hour-long interview into about 15 minutes. So that's a bit of a challenge, but it's just part one, and then we'll go through various editing iterations. But that's where I am right now.
Mate, the level of stuff that you're shooting for us is great. And the thing that jumps out most at me with you is the level of detail on set. We've even had clients saying, you know, wow, this guy really does have everything covered. Remember seeing you on the train, actually, when we were in London, and he had a fucking walkie thing like this, a proper trolley. I've been to London once with all my kit, and I had a camera, a tripod and a camera bag, two things. He pulls out, like Crocodile Dundee, with his trolley, dum, thing over his shoulder, away, he was like, I'm cool. Yeah, you could tell he knew what he was doing. He'd done that a few times, and I was like, I like this guy, he's cool.
Because some of the stuff that we've done in the past is not unusual, maybe a little unorthodox, but they understand that there's method in my madness, I think is what I'm trying to get at, and I appreciate that belief.
Ben, so Ben at the minute, what's Ben working on right now? This looks like a script.
Working on a script for a client who wants an animation doing for their new app.
So Ben basically leads our creative, so we chat with the client. We go through the brief, they tell us what they want, we tell them what they think they should have, and then Ben gets to work on a script. So Ben's, I had your CV in my folder for a long time, and I was looking for somebody to kind of hit the creative project management type of thing, and I remember thinking, I saw this CV somewhere, and I'm so pleased that we brought you in. The experience that you bring, the enthusiasm, you're a very funny guy as well, which I think we need for the creative stuff.
Five.
It's 10.
And yes, you know, it's great for the company that you can do all these multi-skills, and it's massive, massive advantageous for us. And you can see that through the clients, the feedback that we're getting from the clients and the kind of quality of the stuff that we're producing at the minute, that you've directed some of that as well, which is really good. So really pleased about that. Thank you.
Yeah.
Yep.
Nightmare Before Christmas, Tony stole mine, or Miracle on 34th Street.
Kirby had the stress of running Stada Photo for a while, and then eventually I made a decision to bring Kirby in-house, which has worked brilliantly for us. I'm really pleased with how that's worked out. The photography is just, well, goes without saying, you're knocking it out of the park. The photography is insane. But it's not just the skill level of the photography, it's the willingness to learn the video side of it. We've literally just thrown you in there and said, right, now you're going to learn video. And unless you've kind of grown up with video in head, it's not an easy thing to kind of grasp and get hold of, but you're doing really well at that, and I'm really pleased at the progress you're making, and thank you very much. And to keep up the good work. And I believe if I can get the whole team on that same train of thought, that we will get somewhere eventually, and the business will look after those people.
Come on, then, we can all go home. That's the rule, isn't it? We do this, we go home.
If Kat don't come downstairs in a minute, we can all go home, yeah.
Salute!
From Stada Video.
Wait.
Merry Christmas from Stada Video! We're doing that again.
Guys, thank you so much again for all your work, all the effort that you guys put in through the year. Again, as I've said previously, we're a small company. We're kind of trying to get up to that next level, and it's a struggle. It will always be a struggle. It will always be a battle. You know, there's a lot of stuff going on. It's not always going to be good. There's going to be ups and downs and lefts and rights and all over the place.
Merry Christmas from Stada Video. Jeff, we've just been through this.
I just need to stress that, again, we do care as a business. We really, really do. And we'll do whatever we can, whenever we can, to keep you guys happy, keep you in the business as long as we possibly can, because every single person in this room, and Tony, I want you all in the business. You're all in my future plans.
Merry Christmas from Stada Video! Piss up in a brewery. That's enough Christmas for one day.
Right.
Everybody upstairs.
I don't want to hear another word.
Last week, I've had to seriously consider the R word, redundancies within the business, because sometimes you have to swallow your pride, you have to get over yourself, you have to put your business hat on, and you have to be cruel to be kind. And that could involve taking a couple of steps back, which means redundancy. So hopefully that it won't come to that, but this week is a very important week. If we don't get 60-70% of that overdue cash that's due in through the door, then I'm gonna have to start taking action to balance the books.